You know, I think it's like anything. When you realize it a little more, that it's, you know, it's gonna get to the end. You know, we still have to go through the week. The fact that we're playing well too, you know, it kind of rubs it in maybe a little more. You know, and getting some scoring. You know, that's definitely. You know, it's like a little too late, you know, but it's at least it's nice. We're finishing the right way. We got one more to go, and hopefully we'll play a good one tomorrow. If it meant something, I was going to play, but if it doesn't, getting booed for two hours for no reason, I don't know if I was really up to it. If it meant something, I didn't mind, but yeah, when there's something at the line. No, I just, you know, Eddie played well, and he hasn't played much, so no, I've played enough games. We talked about it, like, when there was three games left, what we were going to do. Plans were going to split the first two, and if it meant something, I was going to play, you know, and if not, it was my choice still, but kind of doesn't really matter.
You would have liked to have had a chance to.
Oh yeah, I was stretching out when I saw the score. The 3-2 for Hurricanes, 1-0 Jets. I was on the bench. I was starting to get ready.
What do you remember about this season?
This season?
Yeah, since your season was basically done.
Yeah, well, you know, it was an enjoyable season. You know, compared to the last one, we didn't make the playoff. I think it was really hard. I just felt we played well almost all year. You know, I mean, there's not many, like, weeks that say that we were just awful or we're getting beat up or whatever. You know, like, in a couple of years ago, there's games like 5-1, 6-1. Like, we were just out of it early. But this year didn't happen a lot, you know, and I thought we competed real well. Just, you know, it got hard because of some of the streaks we got, you know, and that really affected our standings, you know. And but, you know, I had a good time. You know, I mean, I came back, you know, last year knowing that, you know, it was a good bunch of guys, good coaches, you know, like make the game fun. And they did again, even though, you know, we're not moving forward. And that's the plan. I'd rather not have fun and then move forward. But, you know, I mean, on the flip side, you know, I mean, I felt good in that when I played, you know, and that's, you know, beside my injury, you know, I mean, both, you know, I can't, for me, it's like I took a middle off there, you know, yeah. It was like I played 2/3 of the year and I felt great, but just, again, you know, the timing of everything, defense and offense, you know, during these streaks were just not there.
Everybody talks about the Stanley Cup hangover for winners, but four of the last 11 Stanley Cup finalists that lost missed the playoffs the next season. Is there something to getting that far in the postseason and not winning that hasn't been an impact in the
experience? I mean, at the end of the day, we played the same amount of games as the team that won it, you know, with the disappointment instead of the joy. I don't know if there's a big effect, you know. It's not like after a month into the lockout, we're like, wow, this is not bad, you know. I mean, we needed that month rest, but after 4 months, we're like, all right, let's go. You know, let's start playing, you know. So it's kind of, that's probably what we had to go through more than anything. But again, you know, it's not like last year we dominated. You know, we're just competing. You know, I think they're compete level. And that's why we got breaks last year. We played the 82 game season. If this year, I'm pretty positive that if we did play 82 games, going to the Western Conference, it would have been a different outcome for us. But you know what? This is what we were dealt with, and it was not enough. You know, but we competed as well as we did last year, you know, with, you know, having, you know, less Zach, you know, less couple, you know, Sicky that scored 20 goals. And, you know, it's just, you don't like to make excuses because we got to get it done. But, you know, I think you always judge your season and how guys want to compete for themselves. And I think we've done that. It just was not enough on a 48-game season.
Is there any concern that for next season, instead of doing whatever's needed to get it back into the playoffs, the risk of going the other direction?
There's always a risk, you know, because we don't have the checkbook to figure that out. You know, I'm sure if any of us have the checkbook, you want to make sure you get in the playoffs. But, you know, I mean, this organization will make decision for the way that they want to run the team, you know. But, you know, for me, I didn't come here not to challenge to make the playoffs, and not come here, but stay here, I would say. not to be able to compete, you know, and so I expect fully that Lou is going to go out and make this team as good or better than what we have now.
If the cap allows him to.
Yeah, that's mean, but that's everybody's going to be like that, so there'll be a lot of guys that are going to be laying off that time buyout or whatever they have. But that's, again, you know, everybody's going to have the same amount of money, and we're going to have a lot of room. It's just a matter of how he manages that room. You know, that's up to them to decide what they want to do with that. You know, like one of the biggest thing, I think it's our fans this year. Like, I mean, we have to be really excited about the outcome of the attendance we had in the shortened season after a lockout. I didn't expect that at all. The support was tremendous. So I feel bad for them a little bit this year that they can't celebrate the playoffs.
He's never really been a guy that's like, oh, I hope this guy is back. He always wanted everyone to be back. We never seem to have worried that much about it. But it seems that you got Patty up, you got Corky up, you got Zuby up, you have a lot of guys up. Does that concern you more than maybe in past years?
A little bit, you know, and definitely these guys are a big core of our team, you know. Guys that like to play here, you know, all three of them, you know, they express that feeling that they want to stay, they want to play here. But again, depending on what the market is allowing them to do, you know, that's where we're going to get our answers, you know. I got pulled. That's about it.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's been a long time. Long time. I don't remember when. And it was when I was getting pulled. I think I must have started most. Yeah.
Shouldn't you have a hand in the changes in the off season to prepare for your career for general manager?
I wish, like everybody, I'm sure you'd love to,
sure.
You know, I mean, that's the beauty of having his job, you know, he's the one that makes all this decision and get that puzzle together, you know, so it's kind of, it's interesting. I'll be watching it, trust me, closely, but I don't think I'm going to have any say in it.
It's like playing fantasy hockey.
Yeah, that's right, exactly, but he's doing it for real, so.